Hi, I'm Rosie Hoyles. Most of you will know me already, but if you don't, I'm a trustee here at Yeovil Community Church, and this is my finance update for quarter two of the year. So quarter one, we were super happy with. It completely went to the plan. Quarter two is very, very similar. We've had some really good news with the lottery funding coming in and some extra funding from the council, which I will talk about in a little bit more detail in a minute. The only thing that is a slight surprising quarter two, but not massive, is we have invested a little bit more in the building with some security and some of our door panels, etc., which isn't a problem. It's just kind of investing for the future, really. So, but it's slightly higher than we probably expected at the start of the year, but it's not a major impact into the budget. So the lottery funding, we have secured lottery funding for 5 years, which is amazing and a real blessing to us. Just a little bit more on the lottery funding. It is phased out over 5 years. So the first year is 100% and we get the full amount to run the programme. That will start to go down in year two, go down even further in year three, four and five. So we still have a little bit of work to do in those final few years to get the funding secured to be able to run the same programme we did in year one to year five. That work will be ongoing over the next year or two, but it isn't a 5 year full 100% funding. We do need extra funding to compensate to be able to run the full programme. In addition to the lottery funding, we have been blessed with £25,000 from Yeovil Town Council for 3 years. That 3 years does have a break clause in between every year. So although they have committed to the 3 years, they are able to pull out after every year if they are under financial stress or something. So we do have to bear that in mind in our decision making. And that all paints a bigger picture in that any decision making we are making at this point, we are trying to bear in mind year one to year five. We aren't making decisions for year one and having to retract them in year two, three, four and five. We're trying to make sustainable decisions, which means we are trying to think of how that impacts staff, how that impacts the programs, and whether we can actually deliver the same program we can in year one and deliver that for the whole 5 years, which obviously means that we'll have to forecast a little bit more, and we are doing all that work behind the scenes. So a lot of work is going into how we utilise that funding and make sure we have a sustainable programme for all the families that we help. Alongside our new version of Y4F, as I put it, we do obviously have the Welcome Hub and the Roost, and that is funded on a yearly basis up to, at the moment, March 25. We envisage that staying for the years after that, but we have no fixed funding on that basis. So we don't have that secured for the 5 years like the lottery funding. That is usually secured around the end of a year to make sure we're fully up to date in terms of where our funding is going to be for the next year. But we won't probably be able to update on that until the very latter of this year, if not the early start of 2025. So just kind of something to acknowledge is that we have that funding for now. There is no guarantee that that funding continues to the end of 2025. A lot of you will be aware, we have the restricted side of the funding, which funds all our programmes. That's where money comes in and we have to spend it on specific things. We also have an overseas mission fund in that side, a building fund in that side. We then have the unrestricted side. This is our pot of money that we get to choose what we spend it on. This pot is very much decided on a whole range of things. So this includes all our donations that people give, and thank you very much for everybody who gives. This also includes a management charge that we transfer from the restricted side to the YCC side, which covers things like the building usage that covers the whole of the organisation and things like that. In transition between our funding from the council, where it was kind of for Y4F a few years ago, and the Welcome Hub, that management charge has dramatically reduced. We think we are in a much better sustainable position now, but it has meant that we have had to make some really hard decisions to maintain the YCC side of operations and to deliver essentially the same amount. I think everybody in the whole organisation has done an amazing job to maintain things like our youth work, our production, our Sunday mornings, like everything we do, we haven't actually noticed a massive operational deficit considering the amount of money that has actually been lost from the pot. So I just want to say a massive thank you to all the staff and everybody who's been involved in those decision makings and how to make everything operational, because I know there's a lot of people in this organisation who have worked probably a tremendous amount of hours. I know there's been overtime going on. I know there's been a lot to deliver the same amount of operational output with that much lesser pot. So yeah, it's been an amazing effort from everybody. But essentially, going forward, we are in a really, really sustainable position on the YCC side. So as I said before, if the Welcome Hub, for an unknown reason, did get kind of reduced or cut, like the Y4F income did, we would be able to pretty much sustain everything we do on the YCC side without much of an impact now, which is amazing and a great position to be in. And if anything, the YCC side is now supporting those restricted programs, which again, where everybody has kind of responded and increased their giving, that is now actually going towards those programs as well as funding everything YCC does, which is, yeah, amazing. So what are our next steps in finance? So in September, I'll be having conversations with all the budget holders. We will begin through 2025 budget, which seems quite early in September, and I'm sure people will love me coming back after the summer and having all those conversations once they're trying to get back into the swing of things for the new term. But we will be trying to plan ahead, make sure that we're having all the conversations to make sure we have everything kind of planned in for 2025. Just a date for your diaries, the AGM is the 18th of September, and instead of doing one of these videos, I will probably just give an update on that night. So just be aware of that my next video update will probably be not till the start of 2025 now for the end of the financial year. So my next update will be at the AGM. And a very final thing from me, I just want to say a massive thank you to Sarah Ruffsage, and she will hate me for doing this, but she has stepped down as a trustee and she was in our finance team. So just a massive thank you from me to her and from our team for everything you did for us. But that does mean we are one short in the finance team. So if you have an interest in finance and want to come and help me and Keith Foy, who is currently also in the finance team, I'd be very willing to have a conversation with anybody who thinks they fit that box. Thank you.